Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Inna alhamdulillahi nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruh. Wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyati a'malina. Man yahdihillahu fala mudilla lah, wa man yudlil fala hadiya lah. Wa ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu amma ba'd. Fa inna azdaqal hadithi kitabullahi ta'ala wa khayral hadi hadi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa sharral umuri muhdathatuha, wa kulla muhdathatin bid'a, wa kulla bid'atin dalalah, wa kulla dalalatin finnar. My dear little children, I welcome you back to our Ramadan school series. Tonight is the night of the 29th of Ramadan, 1442 years after the Hijrah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which coincides with May 11, 2021. Since Ramadan is coming to an end and it's almost over, and we are approaching the great celebration of the Eid, let's learn something important from the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, how to make our Eid or celebrate our Eid the Sunni way. I'm sure you have heard this word Sunni. We say we are Sunni. What does it mean? It's very simple. It's just not a title. If we call ourselves Sunni, that means we are saying that we have committed ourselves to the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. Which means that whenever we do something in our religion, we must make sure that what we do to please Allah in our religion, it must match the Prophet's way. If it doesn't match the Prophet's way, it will be the wrong way, which is known as the innovation way or the bid'i way. So, inshallah, we will try to learn to celebrate the Eid according to the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. Our Prophet ﷺ and the companions, and today actually mainly we're going to talk about the Takbeer of the Eid, and inshallah in the next class we're going to talk about the etiquettes of the Eid. Today we're going to talk about what? The Takbeer of the Eid. Our Prophet ﷺ and the Sahaba, as we will see from some of the examples, they used to do the Takbeer of the Eid from the time they would leave home for the Eid prayer. This is the Takbeer of the Eid for Eid al-Fitr. It does not start from the day before or the night before. It starts from the time you will leave home to go to the Eid musallah to pray your Eid. You start your Takbeer of the Eid. How do we know? We have some reports which are authentic. One of them is reported by Imam Zuhri. This is Muhammad ibn Shihab Zuhri, and the chain of narration is authentic. He said that Allah's Messenger ﷺ would leave his house on the day of Eid al-Fitr, saying Takbir until he reached the musallah to perform the salah. Once he had performed the salah, he would stop saying the Takbir. So this narration is very clear. However, this narration is not from a Sahabi, it is from a Tabi'i. So we have a report also from the Sahabi called Abdullaah ibn Umar, Abdullah the son of Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu. He said that Allah's Messenger ﷺ would go out on both of the days of Eid, Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha, and he would go with these children, Fadl ibn Abbas, his cousin, Abdullah ibn Abbas, his cousin, Al-Abbas, his uncle, Ali ibn Abi Talib, his cousin and also his son-in-law, Ja'far ibn Abi Talib, this is his cousin, Al-Hasan, this is his grandson, Al-Husayn, his grandson, Usamah ibn Zayd, this is the child of his one of the boys he grew up in his home, Zayd ibn al-Harithah also was included, and Ayman ibn Ayman. All of these people, they would be accompanying the Prophet ﷺ, and the Prophet ﷺ would be raising his voice with tahleel and takbir, and would take the way of al-had-dadayn until they would reach the musallah, and he would finish the salah, and he would return to the way of al-hadh-dhayn, and he would return home. So he would go from one way and he would come from the other way. That's basically how he used to go to the Eid musallah. And the point over here is he would raise his voice with the takbir and tahleel. Takbir means Allahu Akbar, tahleel la ilaha illallah, as we will see from the reports. Another authentic report on the authority of Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, his student Nafi, who was also the freed slave, he said that Kana Ibn Umar Kana Yakhruju Yawm al-Fitri, he would get out of the home or leave the home on the day of Fitr wa yawmul adha, and also the day of Adha, Eid al-Adha, yukabbiru. He would make the takbir, yarfa'u bidhalika sawtahu. He would raise his voice with it, hatta yaji'u al-musallah, until he would go to the musallah. And the chain of narration is authentic. Another narration from Abdullah ibn Zubayr. This was also a young child in the time of the Prophet ﷺ. He came out from he came out on the day of Eid and he saw that the people are not making takbir. And this is something that is very not correct. Lot of us, we are coming out of the home and we are just chatting with each other. And if they're making takbir, they're making takbir like this. This is not the way to make takbir. Takbir should be made loudly. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. Not like Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Not like so quietly. Some children, they're very shy. You should not be shy about these things. Some children were very shy in giving salam. When they're saying hello and hi, hey, hello and hi. What, when salam? Salam alaikum. Like that. Should not be like that. You should be open, very clear, because through this you are going to get the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anyway, Abdullah ibn Zubayr, when he saw that, he said, why don't you make takbir? By Allah. Then he took an oath by Allah. He said, since they stopped, meaning since you stopped making takbir, let me tell you. He said, let me tell you what used to happen when I was growing up. He said, you would see us in a large group, the end of which you cannot see on the day of Eid. A man would make takbir, and those who are around him would make takbir loudly. Okay? Not following each other, but you know, being encouraged by the takbir. And they would resonate, the takbir would resonate loudly. And between you and them is the distance of the lowest of the earth and the highest of the heaven. Which means he's saying that there is a big difference between you and them. You don't practice Islam like the way they practice Islam. So he was admonishing them for not making the takbir or being silent about it. And this is a very big problem. Huh? If you little children, the youth, you don't express yourself like the way the Sahaba did, you will not be able to practice the Islam like the way they did. And it's pretty simple. It is not something complicated. It's very simple. You just say these words loudly. Don't fear anybody. Don't be shy about your religion. Don't be shy to express the greatness of Allah. This is, look at the Christians. When it comes to their Christmas, which is not a holy celebration, it is not from Allah. But see how proud they are of their celebration. They wear a big cross, they dance and they sing and all sorts of, the Santa Claus is everywhere, and all of this is not worshipping Allah. So if they are so proud about proclaiming their kufr and their falsehood, why should be so shy about proclaiming the greatness of Allah? How this non-Muslim will know about the religion of Islam if we are always shy about our religion? We should not be like that. Also, another narration in Sahih al-Bukhari and Muslim on the authority of Mu'atiyah radiallahu anha, she said that we used to be ordered to come out on the day of Eid, and even were ordered to bring out our children, our girls who were not married. They were shy and they were staying home. We were ordered to bring all of them out. And by the way, when they used to come out, they were supposed to wear the full jilbab. The full jilbab, which is the long dress, and the full khimar, the abaya, to cover themselves completely. This is how the girls in the time of the Prophet ﷺ, they were. They also wanted to decorate themselves. We have narrations, they used to have jewelries, holi, in their hands, in their fingers, and in their feet, you know, big amount of jewelries. But they were not supposed to show it out when they would go out. This is how those women were. She said, we were commanded to take them out and we would stand behind the women, men, okay, and say the takbir along with them. And invoke Allah along with them, with the men, and hope for the blessings of that day. Barakah of that day. Barakata dhalika al-yawm wa tuhratahu, to seek the barakah, the blessings and the purification. So this day has blessings and this day has purification. And we cannot seek it our way. So if you go there and you say, look around and most of the kids are there chatting with each other. No. You should make takbir, you should be zealous to establish this on the day of Eid. All the time we chat. if you're going to do the same thing on the day of Eid, when we are supposed to make the takbir, this is not good. Then we'll not be able to seek the barakah and the blessings like the way as-sahabat al-kiram and these women, they used to do in the time of the Prophet ﷺ. Now, how to make the takbir? We have some narrations from the sahaba, mainly from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud and Abdullah ibn Abbas, and the chain of narrations are authentic. I'm going to only mention two of them so that it's made easy for you, and these terms are very easy. You already know them. The takbir of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud is Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Who doesn't know Allahu Akbar? Allahu Akbar means Allah is the greatest, or it also means Allah is greater, greater than anything and everything. Okay, so you say three times Allahu Akbar, then the tahleel, La ilaha illallah, which means there is no one worthy of worship except Allah. Then Wallahu Akbar, and Allah is the greatest, Allahu Akbar, Walillahi alhamd, and all praise be to Allah. And all praise be to Allah. That's basically the takbir. So how do you say it? You just say it loudly. Men, women, children, young, old, everybody, loudly say it. We don't have to say it in a chorus. That is an innovation. That's not correct. You go to some of these places and some of them is holding the microphone and saying Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah. This is good if you do like individually, but everybody in a chorus, this is not the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. We should have our own takbir and we should say loudly. We don't have to say it in a certain rhythm. Okay? Another narration with Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, which says only two times Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Wallahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Walillahi alhamd. So you can do two times Allahu Akbar, then La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Walillahi alhamd, or three times Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Walillahi alhamd. This is the takbir of the Prophet, the Sahabat al-Kiram radiallahu anhum. And we should stick to that. Some people that add more, Allah Alhamdulillah Kathira, wa Subhanallah Bukrata wa Asila, and they add more things. We don't have to do that. We just stick to a Sahaba, what the Sahabat al-Kiram, they established it, and all of these are inshallah ta'ala authentic. So we learn from all of these narrations that takbir is very important. And think about this, this special takbir, it's only for a very limited time in Eid al-Fitr. From the time you leave home until you get to the musallah, and the imam comes, you stop the takbir. If he makes the takbir, you make the takbir with him. And after the prayer, the takbir finishes. No more takbir. No more takbir. So, this small amount of time, don't waste it. Do not waste it. Let's try to magnify or glorify the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the bottom of our heart. It's not a ritual that we just say in our mouth and our mind is thinking about something else. We focus in really glorifying Allah, in really making Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the one ilah, the one God, and really praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all of the good things He has given us. Think about it, your family, your parents, your grandparents, your cousins, your friends, your school, all the fun that you have, the toys, the games, the vacation, the food, everything that you have, the car, the house, all the good things that you enjoy. Is there anything that is not from Allah? Everything is from Allah. So these are the times that we should pour our heart to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and thank Him and glorify Him for the great blessings that He has given us. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.